First up is what I believe is actually an A Metallica, also known as the Metallic Pink Toe. Now, this was sold to me, or this was sold to my friend as an AA Vic, or just a common pink toe, but there's a few things I'm seeing that have stuck out to me that make me think this may actually indeed be a Metallica. For one, the larger size. I mean, granted, this individual is not full grown, but even then, I mean, if it is an AA Vic, she's probably close to max size, because those only get about 4 to 5 inches in leg span, whereas the Metallicas can reach 6.5, sometimes 7 inches in some of the larger females. Also, I know you can't see her abdomen right now, but AA Vics, they have very prominent reddish brown hairs on the abdomen, whereas the Metallica does not. Also, the toes, or the foot pads on this species, they have white tips, which you can't really tell, as opposed to more of a overall reddish pink like the AAVIX do. And then also, this species has some very prominent white hairs on the legs, which the common pink toe does not. But anyway, yeah, this one here, she hasn't made a web yet, as you can see, which I don't know if anyone else in the hobby has noticed this. Please, if you do, by all means, drop me a comment. The Metallicas, though, they don't seem to web quite as much as some of the other pink toes, and even when they do, it seems to take them quite a while to settle in before doing so. Maybe that's just the individuals that I've kept, or maybe it's the larger ones, because I know a couple of folks who have this species, who have acquired this species as spiderlings, and they seem to web up fairly quickly, as well as produce quite a bit of webbing, so maybe that's why. But anyway, she's still settling in, probably. But yeah, I'm super excited about that one. A Metallica is, I know they're not anything special to a lot of people, but that was actually the first pink toe tarantula that I had ever acquired, was a Metallica, so it holds a special place in my heart. And up next, we've got a confirmed subadult female, Brachypelma smithii, also known as the Mexican red knee. This species, I believe, also recently got reclassified as a Brachypelma hermani, although I've seen some information saying that they might be either two completely different species, or one is a subspecies of the other. It's honestly rather confusing, even to somebody like myself, who has been in this hobby for some time. Me go ahead and remove the lid here so you guys can really see her colors. She is quite a beauty. As you can see, she's still rather small. These guys tend to get pretty large as far as tarantulas go. Usually they reach about a 6, though I've seen some that were pushing 7 inches with females. That is, males tend to stay quite a bit smaller, more in like the 5, 5.5 inch range. So far, she hasn't really eaten a ton, which is kind of a bummer. The last smithy I had, which sadly turned out to be male, was a pretty voracious eater. So, it could very well be that she's in pre-mold, or she's just well fed, or she's just more of a finicky eater. But yeah, there she is. Actually, believe it or not, I have not kept a whole ton of brachies, which might come off as kind of a shock to people, considering that they're such a prominent species in the hobby, especially amongst novice keepers. I actually wanted to acquire one of these as my first tarantula, but I did not have the money, seeing as to how they're a bit more on the pricey side. So I had to go with the G. Rosea. Anyway, yeah, she, as you can see, she's a little bit on the jumpy side. Not quite as calm as I would like her to be, but who knows, maybe she'll mellow out over time. She's far from defensive, she just tends to be very trigger happy with her urticating hairs. And last but certainly not least, one of my all-time favorites, I have here a Chromatopelma cyanopubescens, aka Green Bottle Blue. This is a sling, as you can see. She's only about inch and a half, almost 2 inches. She's still got her spiraling color there with the tiger abdomen and then the golden carapace. This is one of my all-time favorite species, though. They are absolutely drop-dead gorgeous, especially as adults, when they've got that bright neon blue carapace and then the blue legs. They lose the tiger striping on the abdomen, but they keep the orange coloration, which is awesome. They are truly a sight to behold. Oh, I guess she's not a fan of the lighting here. One thing I will say about the species is I've seen people recommend them to beginners on a lot of the arachnid forums that I've browsed over the years. And I don't know if I can 100% agree with that because they are fairly quick. They're not as fast moving as some of the old worlds, but they have been known to bolt quite a bit. At least the ones that I have kept have. And they are pretty high strung. They are far from what I would consider handleable tarantulas. But they are absolutely stunning. As you can see, they are very prominent webbers. So if you're looking for a webber, you cannot go wrong here. They're very, very hardy tarantulas. And they have one of the best feeding responses I have ever seen. These guys are literally like garbage disposals. And they are absolutely fearless. I've seen this spiraling tackle crickets as large as itself, which granted I don't recommend normally giving them something that's any larger than the abdomen. That's a good rule of thumb when it comes to feeding any tarantula, not just spiralins, but with this species I feel that they're able to handle it with most prey items, that is. But anyway, yeah, so those are my three new additions. I definitely look forward to showing them off some more to you guys. I'm actually planning on doing another feed-in video fairly soon, so that's something to look forward to. And with that being said, please, if you like this video, go ahead, like, subscribe, all that jazz, and I look forward to seeing you guys in the next one. Peace.